When you give adolescents cars, you sometimes end up with something like this. Adolescents account for something like 36% of vehicle accidents, even though they make up less than 20% of all drivers on the road. This is part of the reason why insurance companies charge adolescents a lot of money to insure their cars, because adolescents have a tendency to wreck their cars. There are other examples of adolescent judgment problems. We've seen headlines like this many times. Teenage hosts of Facebook-organized party turned riot. Basically, teenagers throwing a party while their parents are away, and hundreds of people show up unexpectedly. The party gets out of hand. People throw bricks through walls and knock over mailboxes, causing hundreds and thousands of dollars in damage to the parents' house. Again, more examples where adolescents are maybe having some trouble with decision-making. More trouble with decision-making. This is called tombstoning. That is a 100-foot drop into water nobody knows the depth of. But it's really impressive. This is off the fort at the Portsmouth Harbor in England. What's interesting is that there are some traditional societies where cliff diving like this is actually a rite of passage for adolescent boys that's built into the culture. It turns out that boys in England have found this traditional rite of passage all on their own. And I have to say that cliff diving was common where I grew up too, but every year someone, almost always an adolescent, was airlifted out of the river as a result. This is incredibly dangerous, but adolescents still tend to do it. This is part of that sensation seeking and the reward of having all of your friends think you're amazing. Other issues of adolescent risk taking. How many of you knew that you can ingest vodka through your eyeball? It's possible, but don't do that. The alcohol can cross the blood-brain barrier through the eye really fast. It's also really bad for you. You can lose your eye. You can ingest the alcohol so fast that you can die. Adolescents do these sorts of things that are possible but not really advisable, and it's not something you see adults doing generally. Other things you don't see adults doing: beer bongs. I haven't seen a beer bong in a party for a good number of years. Things like beer pong, flip cup, and other drinking games all encourage lots of drinking, but risky kinds of drinking, particularly rapid binge drinking. Those sorts of things where you can ingest so much that it will hurt your body or kill you before you know it's happened. Those are the kinds of risk-taking behaviors that seem to appear only in adolescents. This is not something that you see adults doing. So why do we really see only adolescents doing these crazy things?